Hello, in our today's video lecture, we will prove the Einstein equation, which is E is equal to mc square. This is one of the most famous equation of physics and was obtained by Einstein from the postulates of special theory of relativity. There are two methods to derive this equation. One is dimensional method, while the other is mathematical method. We will use these two methods to derive this equation. The first method, dimensional method, is very simple. We know that the work done is equal to F dot ds, where the force F is equal to ma and the a acceleration is equal to v by t. So putting the value for a is equal to v by t, we will get W is equal to m by t dot s. Now we write this t below the s, so the equation becomes W is equal to mv dot s by t. This mv is also known as the momentum term, but here we will express it as mv. W is equal to mv dot v. This s by t is distance divided by time, and distance divided by time is equal to velocity, so we get W is equal to mv square. Now if we replace the v velocity term by the speed of light, which is also a velocity, as c is equal to v, we will get the new equation W is equal to mc square, where W of the work done is energy, and we can write it as E is equal to mc square. This equation does not include the gamma term. Here in our second method, we will use the relativity that will include the gamma term, and that is one of the most valid equation used in the physics. Now here we use the second method, which is mathematical method. In this method, we begin from the kinetic energy, which is equal to the work done or the work integral of F dot ds. Now, in relativity, the force F is equal to gamma ma, and this gamma is a relativistic term. Now here, the acceleration is equal to dv divided by dt. So we can write this equation as d by dt into gamma mv, where gamma is the relativistic term and is equal to 1 over under root 1 minus v square by c square. Now putting the value for f in this equation, we will get kinetic energy is equal to 0 to v d by dt into gamma mv dot ds. Now we replace this ds with ds by dt. This dt shift from d by dt to ds by dt. The remaining terms now are d gamma mv into ds by dt. Here we will get a new equation from 0 to v d gamma mv dot v. This ds by dt is the velocity term. So the new equation we have is kinetic energy is equal to v into d gamma mv. Now we integrate this equation using integration by parts. The formula for integration by parts is given as. Now here, this is the first term, this is the second term, is uv minus integral of this term dot dv, similarly like this. So integrating by parts, we will get this new equation, kinetic energy is equal to velocity into gamma mv minus integral gamma mv dot dv. Now the gamma is equal to 1 over under root 1 minus v square by c square. Putting the value for gamma, we will get v dot 1 over under root 1 minus v square by c square mv minus, putting the value for gamma here in this equation, we will get minus 0 to v integral 1 under root 1 minus v square by c square into mv dot dv. Now, this m is constant, so we can write this equation as minus m 0 to v into 1 minus v square by c square whole ki power minus 1 over 2. As we shift this term to on the upper side, this will shift from 1 over 2 to minus 1 over 2. The sign of this 1 over 2 will change. So we write it as 1 minus v square by c square whole ki power minus 1 over 2. This v remain here v dot dv. Now, to make this equation easier for integration, we multiply this equation with c square by minus 2 and dividing by c square by minus 2 by c square. We write this equation as minus mc square by minus 2 into 0 to v 1 minus v square by c square whole ki power minus 1 over 2 into minus 2 by c square. This minus 2 by c square is balanced by this c square by minus 2 into v dot dv. Now we can integrate this term very easily. Now integrating this term, we will get minus mc square by minus 2 is constant, so we write it here, and the remaining terms is we will add minus 1 over 2 plus 1 divided by minus 1 over 2 plus 1. Now, this is simple mathematics. Hope you understand this. Kinetic energy becomes equal to mv square by under root 1 minus v square by c square plus this plus this minus and minus plus mc square by 2 1 minus v square by c square minus 1 over 2 plus 1 is equal to 1 over 2. Similarly, this minus 1 over 2 plus 1 over 2 equal to 1 over 2. And the limits are from 0 to v. Now, these two will cancel out with this two, and the remaining term will be mc square into 1 minus v square by c square whole ki power 1 over 2 0 to v. 0 to v. Now we put the limits in this term. By putting the limit in this term, first we will put v, we will get 1 minus v square by c square whole ki power 1 over 2. Now for the second term, now we will put 0. When we put 0 in this equation, we will get, when this becomes 0, then 0 by c square is equal to 0, 1 minus 0, and under root 1 is equal to 1. So the remaining term is minus 1. Now we multiply this . Now here the equation become kinetic energy is equal to mv square under root 1 minus v square by c square plus mc square into 1 minus v square by c square 1 over 2 minus 1. Now we simplify this equation. First we multiply this mc square with this term become mc square into 1 minus v square by c square, and this was the one. When the mc square multiply with the 1, we got minus mc square. Now taking LCM for this term, we will get under root 1 minus v square by c square. This mv square remain here, and this will become plus mc square under root 1 minus v square by c square whole to power 1 over 2 and square. These two will cancel with these two, and the remaining term will be mc square under root 1 minus v square by c square. When this term multiply with this term, we will get mv square plus mc square minus mc square v square by c square divided by under root 1 minus v square by c square, and this minus mc square is here. Now in this equation, this c square will cancel with this c square, and the remaining term is minus mv square. Now this minus mv square will cancel out with plus mv square, and the remaining term will be plus mc square divided by 1 minus v square by c square minus mc square. Now the kinetic energy is equal to mc square, this mc square under root 1 minus v square by c square minus mc square. This is the minus mc square term. And this 1 over under root 1 minus v square by c square is equal to gamma. So we can write this equation as gamma mc square minus mc square, which is equal to gamma minus 1 into mc square. This result states that the kinetic energy of an object is equal to the difference between gamma mc square and mc square. So this is the difference between gamma mc square and minus and mc square. This can also be written as gamma mc square is equal to kinetic energy plus mc square. Now here in this equation, where energy is equal to gamma mc square is the total energy. The kinetic energy is this term, and this term is the rest energy and can be written as E naught is equal to mc square. So this E naught is equal to mc square is the rest energy. We can write this equation as E is equal to kinetic energy plus E naught, where E is equal to gamma mc square is the total energy, E naught is equal to mc square is the rest energy, and this term is the kinetic energy. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe easyedu for more videos. Thank you.